Alrighty, this is Kid Steampunk checking out Kona. As it says, it's the early release version of the game. This is a survival, possibly horror game.
Carl Faubert, private detective, had just traveled thousands of kilometers from Montreal to reach this remote middle of nowhere area, situated near the far northern Lake Etobicoke. Granted, this was a great distance to cover for a sole crime, but word had it that he was a particularly wealthy one.
Ah, that's much better.
I had to drive a bit further north in order to meet with wealthy industrialist William Hammond. Hamilton was a prosperous owner who had acquired various businesses as well as metal mines in this northern region. Hamilton is waiting for Carl in the general store. It was time for him to get down to business.
Why is my character narrating to himself? I need something to break that lock with.
Hamilton will have new who manage the target. Carl wanted to give him happen too easy then, as sure enough the wine was acting up.
Of course it was. Why wouldn't it be? Weird. Something's unlocked. There we go. Useful tools. You don't want to take anything else in there? Like that socket wrench? Saw a shiny and new. Guess not. Okay.
Make quick work of the chain. What better way to investigate vandals than to get into their shoes? Carl, the professional vandal, reveling in the irony of the situation.
Good Lord. I'm missing something? Nope, don't think so.
But he had to stay focused on the task at hand.
Whoa! Well, that did not go well.
Given the circumstances, leaving with an empty tank would be a death warrant. Carl had to refuel.
Carl parked 20 miles. Yeah, empty up. What the shit? Oh, that's bad. Right. Use a flashlight. Got it. Okay, no, not that. There we go. Wow, we got cold in here quick.
The note explained that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time. Explain that the garage and the store couldn't be supplied with electricity at the same time.
Well, that was worth a try. Now I get to go outside and probably get scared. Yay! Fucking wolves! Oh, there's a generator. I need tape and scissors? Come on, close the door. There you go. Alright, we need tape and scissors. Freaky ass place. That is full of dust. 0-2. There we go.
Finding a key is easy. Finding the right keyhole, not so much.
Hey, there's a letter here.
Jim Lachance, Carl recollected, was the general store's manager. Should have a Hamilton not be available, he was the man to talk to. Or if Hamilton had moved up his appointment with his position. Whatever happened here, things got pretty rough, and not a trace of Hamilton.
Well, we're just opening people's mail, why not? See if I got everything I needed. Nope, didn't find good. Did the door really have to be as far away as possible? God damn it. Oh, so much better. Wow, look at that. My truck magically got where I needed it to be. Why would you tell me that now? Awesome.
Road turned into nothing. Arnold hated that end. Made him look around. It seemed like the lake managed to completely swallow the road. The Polaroid, Carl's long-standing and faithful ally, had seen a share of husbands caught red-handed cheating. There's always something out there waiting to be snapped away.